Hey guys, Kronegger here.
Hola and welcome back to the channel, you lovely people. Today we're gonna talk about a weapon that is absolutely the business. The Maliwan Rocket Launcher, the Hive. Such a classic. It's been around since Borderlands 2 and is still buzzing in Borderlands 3. Now let's take a look at how this bad boy has changed in its game and have some fun, shall we? So anyways, the Hive launches a projectile that slowly rises into the air and shoots two homing rockets in all directions every 2 seconds. They can travel a considerable distance and they do corrosive splash damage upon impact. So be careful because they can hurt the player or players if you're in co-op. Now, the main projectile lasts 7 seconds and after that it explodes. It actually reminds me of me doing planks. It is recommended to fire the Hive onto the ground or ceiling since the homing rockets will always be released horizontally. If it is used too close to a wall, it will make it waste shots directly into that wall, and this is why you should not use the Hive in very enclosed places. Now, when we talk about the Hive, it's impossible not to talk about the grog nozzle, the ultimate drinking buddy for the Hive. Like many other rocket launchers, the Hive benefits a lot from the drunk effect. Oh wait, that's not enough for you, you say? Okay, let me add the B-Shield. You know, all the child rockets get full amp damage. FULL AMP DAMAGE! This interaction enables Borderlands 2 easy mode, like seriously, nothing stands a chance. Saturn... Nope. Reskin Saturn... Nope. Raid bosses? Well, maybe Hyperius, because his HP is glitched and he's dead too, okay. On top of this, you could add the Ahab glitch, boosting the Hive unlisted projectiles even more. Balance, yes, how the developers intended it to be. But if you're not a fan of getting drunk and want to use the Hive sober, well, good luck. You'll find a limited rocket launcher that is locked to one element, and as you already know, Corrado would deal less damage to anything that is not armored. It's not ammo efficient, it actually has a very high ammo consumption, and I believe it's the only rocket launcher in Borderlands 2 that consumes 4 ammo per shot. And also it's a weapon with the slowest reload speed in Borderlands 2. Yay, so efficient! The Hive is not the best rocket launcher out there, not the worst either, but it sure is a fun one to use, especially when you want to get rid of those annoying surveyors. Don't you just hate those things? Let me know in the comments. The Hive in Borderlands 3 is definitely an improvement. Even if there was a grog nozzle in Borderlands 3, the Hive could not need it. That's how good it is. Although this wasn't always the case, back in the day when we had Mayhem 4, the Hive was a competent rocket launcher, until the nation of Mayhem 2.0 attacked, and many of the legendary weapons we had became obsolete, including the beloved Hive. Staying like a forgotten weapon for a while. Talking about this brings back memories. When I started YouTube, I had a series talking about forgotten weapons. I might bring it back someday, but I digress. It wasn't until much later that the Hive received a damage buff, and with the addition of new items like the Revolter Shield, the Infernal Wish, the Toboggan Artifact, new skill trees, that the Hive rose from the dead like a phoenix from the ashes, becoming a child of a rocket launcher. It now comes in 2 elements, corrosion, and we got radiation as well. This makes the weapon not as limited as it was in Borderlands 2. You see, corrosion has a damage penalty against flesh and shields, however radiation does not. It's neutral against flesh, it has a damage bonus against shields, but deals less damage to armor. These 2 elements complement each other, and now thanks to anointments, you don't need to have 2 different variants of the Hive. As long as you have an elemental anointment on it, you can combine corrosion and radiation, or cryo and radiation, and you will get the best of both worlds. You know, like the song. The slow reload speed and high ammo consumption are still there, however this time we got ways to mitigate these downsides without the need of exploits or tricks. Need ammo? Well, there is Moe's or the Cat Burst artifact. Need more reload speed? Every hunter has plenty of reloading related skills. Or if you're feeling really fancy, there is the Omni Loader. To some extent, lit or alive also helps. Finally, a lot of people consider this the most important change. Unlike Borderlands 2, this version is much easier to farm. The Hive is a rocket launcher that I would suggest you to use. It deals so much damage, and it interacts so well with the Vault Hunter skills that you can use it on any of them. It procs Burst Pollution and Sane. It's also a good option for the clone. Easy to proc Hollow Point on Flak. Moves can increase the splash damage, radius, and has armor again. Amara can pair it with and with the rainbow and obliterate frozen enemies, and also she can add like 3 more elements to the weapon. But yeah, I'm probably forgetting more things, but the point is, the Hive is good and it's worthy of being a legendary weapon. All in all, the Hive is a rocket launcher that has come a long way since its early days. It's a weapon that with the right setups can hold its own against any enemy. And while it has its downsides, it can deal massive damage and works well with any Vault Hunter in both Borderlands 2 and 3. Don't miss out on the Hive, it's definitely worth giving a shot. That's all I have to say for today. Thank you so much for watching, I really appreciate it, guys. And I hope you have a great day. See you soon. Bye bye.